We get emails every day about various RV topics, but one topic that comes up very frequently is to deal with fifth wheel towing. And these questions usually come in two forms. What RV can I tow with this truck? And what truck do I need to tow this RV? We also see a lot of confusion around pin weight, GVWR, GCWR, GAWR, and all those crazy acronyms. Fifth wheel towing needs to take into account the pin weight and the cargo capacity of the truck, and that just kind of throws a lot of people off. We covered this a little bit 6 years ago. I can't believe it's been that long, but 6 years ago, we made our Tow This Beast video and did a whole towing video, and I talked a little bit about weights then. A lot of you have asked for an update to that video, and we're actually looking for a spot to film that to get some new angles, some new scenarios. I think that'd be a lot of fun, but I wanted to take the time and break out a separate video just about towing weights and numbers when it comes to fifth wheels. This is that video. Note that this is just about fifth wheels. It's not about travel trailers. It's not about Class A's. It's not about anything else but fifth wheels and trucks. So when you hear me say RV in this video, I'm talking about a fifth wheel. When you hear me say rig, I'm usually talking about the whole setup, the truck and the RV together. To me, that's the rig. So what we're going to do is we're going to cover all of those crazy acronyms, GAWR, GVWR, GCWR, and all that crazy stuff. Then we're going to talk about how to use those numbers. Once we understand those numbers, how to use those to pick the right truck for a particular RV. And we're going to flip it up and we're going to talk about how to pick an RV if you already have the truck. So we kind of want to take this from both angles with some real world examples. And then we're going to talk about how to weigh your RV properly for a fifth wheel and then calculate all those crazy acronyms and see if you're towing safely. I'm going to try to cover all the various angles and weird numbers and acronyms, but if I leave anything out, please put them in the comments down below. I really look forward to reading those. There's usually a lot of good stuff down there. So even if you don't have a comment, go check it out down there. But leave a comment if you could. Also, please give this video a thumbs up if you could. That kind of helps the algorithm share the video more. I'd really appreciate it. So let's start with the basics and get all of these crazy acronyms out of the way so we have a good understanding of what we're talking about. First up is GVWR. This is the big one you're going to hear a lot. And that stands for Gross Vehicle Weight Rating. And per the name, each vehicle has its own rating. So you've got a GVWR for your truck, you got a GVWR for your RV. And that is just the maximum that vehicle can weigh and still be safe. The GVWR for any particular vehicle can usually be found in literature. That's typically a published number. It's also going to be on the door sticker. When I say door sticker, that's where it usually is on a truck. In an RV, it's usually on the driver's side where the driver door would be if it had one. When I say vehicle sticker or door sticker, that's what I'm talking about. That door sticker is the final word on what the actual numbers are. So if you see a GVWR online that says something different than the sticker, sticker has final say. Next up is GAWR, or gross axle weight rating. And that is just a rating, same kind of rating, a maximum safe weight per axle. So on a truck, you've got a steer axle, a drive axle, and on an RV, you may have one, two, or three axles. Those are all usually the same weight rating. You won't usually find GAWR online. That is usually going to be on the actual sticker because it's so specific to every vehicle. Next up is GCWR, or gross combined weight rating. And that is just the maximum weight that the entire rig should weigh. And this is usually a rating that you'll have on the actual truck. It's a published number, but that is the maximum weight of the truck and RV together. Next up is UVW, or unloaded vehicle weight, also sometimes called dry weight or curb weight for a truck or vehicle. Now, this is just how much that vehicle weighed coming out of the factory. With all of its options and everything on it, this is how much the vehicle weighs dry with nobody in it. And those last two acronyms bring us to our third number, which is CCC, or cargo carrying capacity, which you will also hear called just cargo capacity, or CC, as well as payload capacity. And this is just basically your GVWR, your maximum weight, minus your unloaded vehicle weight. That gives you how much stuff you can actually put in the vehicle, be that your RV or your truck. This is how much stuff it can carry besides itself. And for the truck, This is the number that's overlooked quite a bit when people start looking at fifth wheel towing, but it's super, super important, as we're going to see. Because our next item up for bids, our next thing we want to talk about is pin weight. And I've never seen an acronym for this, so there's no PW, but your pin weight is the weight of your RV's pin. So your RV has a total weight, and then the weight of the pin that sits in the bed of the truck, that's the pin weight. And usually on a fifth wheel, the pin weight is going to be between 15 and 25% of the overall weight of the RV. So 20% is a good number to use for planning. If you want to be even safer, you can use 25%. When you get into some larger fifth wheels that have drop frames and a bunch of gear up in the front bay, that can easily get up around 22 to 25%. So that's all of our acronyms that we're going to need for this discussion. Now let's take that information and talk about how to properly size a truck if you've already picked out the RV. And that's usually the best way to do it. If you're shopping for a fifth wheel or even a trailer, is to find the RV that suits your needs first before you buy the truck. If you buy the truck first, you're going to be limited by whatever that truck can carry. You might think it's great, but it might not be as great as you think. So in this scenario, we're going to go big and we're going to talk about a GVWR of 20,000 pounds, which is kind of like this RV here, actually 21 on this one. So starting with that 20,000 pound GVWR, we're going to take 20% of that. And I picked 20,000 because it's easy math. So 20% of 20,000 pounds is 4,000 pounds. That is going to be the pin weight that we're going to use for this hypothetical situation here. You always want to use the GVWR of an RV, and of course you can find this online. And you want to use the GVWR for your planning because, trust me, you will max out that RV. It's just going to happen. But remember, we're not talking just about pin weight here. I mean, somebody's got to drive the truck, right? So you also need to include, passengers and pets. Your hitch itself is probably going to be about 100 pounds. You also need to account for things that you're going to want to carry in the truck, like a tool and toolbox and things like that. For this example, we're going to say 400 pounds for passengers and pets, 100 pound hitch, and 300 pounds of tools and toolbox and things like that. So we're looking at 4,800 pounds of cargo that we're going to have in this truck when we're towing. So we've got two numbers that we need to satisfy with our truck. Number one is the actual whole weight of the thing, 20,000 pounds. Your truck needs to have a fifth wheel tow rating of at least 20,000 pounds. Now this number is pretty easy to find in towing guides, so that shouldn't be a problem. And you're going to find that for a 20,000 pound truck, if we look at our Ford guide here, we're only looking at the diesels that are going to be able to handle this. Most of your gas trucks don't have the same pulling capacity because they don't have the horsepower and torque that a diesel does. Be sure you're looking at fifth wheel charts specifically because they do typically have separate charts for bumper pull and for fifth wheel towing. You can see here in the Ford guide for the F350 SRW, that's single rear wheel, another acronym I know, but you're going to see SRW and DRW, and DRW is dual rear wheel, or sometimes called dually. So I'm going to use the term dually and singly, just because I made that up. But the F350 singly, all the diesel options can satisfy our 20K towing requirement. But now we need to look at our cargo capacity requirement of 4,800 pounds. This one can be a little bit trickier as the towing guides don't have as much info on cargo capacity, and where they do, they assume base trim with no options, which the fine print usually regards as minimum equipment or properly equipped in the case of the Ram guides. This is because every truck is built differently. If you build out a Ford XLT versus a Ford Platinum or King Ranch, that Platinum and King Ranch is going to have more stuff on it, and it's going to eat away at that GVWR and give you less cargo capacity. We can use that towing guide as a starting point and knowing that the real cargo capacity is probably going to be a little bit lower, but we have to start somewhere. For Ford, they have this maximum cargo weight of slide and camper chart, so we can use this to get some ideas. And you can see that we need to be looking at the F350 and 450 DRW or dually options. None of the single rear wheel options can handle that 4,800 pounds. Some of them come close, but remember that these are bare bones published numbers and they'll only go down from these numbers. In the same situation, when you look at the Ram charts, we're in dually territory here with a 20K fiber. So now you have an idea of what to shop for. So when you go to the dealer and you go open the door and look at that sticker, you'll know what number you're looking for in terms of your payload capacity. Now there are two stickers in the door jamb of a truck. You've got your one that has your VIN number and your GCWR and your GVWR. And then you have another sticker that has like tire and loading information, and that's gonna have your actual cargo capacity. And that sticker is the final truth. If you're not aware, we only take on sponsors for products and services that we use personally and can recommend personally because we've used them. This product is no different. We've had a Vantrue dash cam in our truck since day one when we picked up our RV, our first RV back in 2017. Why was I so insistent on having a dash cam from the very get-go? Well, I'm a responsible driver, but a lot of people out there are not. And a dash cam and video where it's actually got the GPS coordinates and your speed and everything stamped right on there, video evidence is your biggest friend if you ever have to defend yourself to prove that you are not in the wrong. So we've had a Vantrue dash cam since day one, and it's really given us good peace of mind. Vantrue sent us their brand new model, the Nexus 4 Pro S, to try out, and this thing is loaded with features, and it's my new favorite by far. It records three cameras simultaneously, 4K up front, 2.5K in the back, and 1080p inside, all with HDR clarity. That means sharp details in the bright daylight and at night. This thing uses the latest Sony StarVis 2 sensors and plate picks technology, so even license plates are very clear at night. The rear camera is IP67 waterproof, so you can mount it outside the window, outside of the tent where it belongs, and not worry about rain or road spray. You can transfer files in seconds with this integrated 5.8 gigahertz Wi-Fi and manage everything via the dedicated app, including firmware updates, which I think is cool. It's got built-in GPS, so your location and speed are stamped right on the video. You can even control it by voice, so there's no distractions while driving.
Show rear camera. Show front camera. Lock the video.
Check out the link in the description below to learn more about it and pick up yours. I think you're really going to like it. It's one of the simplest and best upgrades that you can make to your rig and to your peace of mind. Now let's get back in and figure out the flip side of this weight situation. So you've already got a truck and you just want to figure out how much fifth wheel you can tow with that truck. Now this going this direction, obviously you're a little bit more limited because you're going to put a cap on the size of the RV, but it's pretty simple because you already have a definitive answer on your truck's cargo capacity because you've got the truck and you've got your sticker. For our example, let's say your truck sticker says you've got 3,800 pounds of cargo capacity. And let's use our same numbers as before with passengers and pets at 400, hitch at 100, toolbox and tools at 300. So we've got our 3,800 cargo capacity minus the 800 pounds in stuff that we've already got in this truck. And that leaves 3,000 pounds of cargo capacity available for the pin. So if we're going to use our same 20% scenario and say that the pin's going to be 20% of the total weight, it's a simple matter of taking that 3,000 pounds, multiplying it by 5, and coming up with 15,000 pounds. So if you've got this hypothetical truck of 3,800 pound cargo capacity, you want to look for a 15,000 pound GVWR RV or less. So let's talk about how to weigh the rig to make sure all your numbers are where they're supposed to be. You've truck first, RV first, whatever. You've got your truck and your RV and you want to weigh it. As you've probably seen, there are CAT scales at almost every truck stop and they're super easy to use. You can drive up onto them. You'll see that there are three actual scales, one for the steer axle, one for the drive axle on your truck, and then one for the trailer itself. Now you can drive up on those. Some of them have a push button and you can talk to somebody, then go inside and pay. But an even easier way is to download the Weigh My Truck app, sign up for it, register for it, you know, put your credit card information in there before you go. And then because it's GPS located, all you have to do is drive up onto the scale, launch the app, click a few buttons, and get your weights. Now to do this properly, you need to weigh your RV twice. Well, technically your RV once. You need to drive up on the scales with your RV, get a weight ticket, and then go drop the RV off. This is usually easiest to do if you do a CAT scale near a campground where you're staying for the night, because you're not going to be able to just, you can't drop your RV at the truck stop. You just can't. So get your weight, go set up camp, whatever, drop off your RV, and then come back to that same scale and weigh again with just your truck. If you do this within 24 hours, you can do what's called a reweigh, and it's, I think, like $4 instead of $14. We also want to make sure that your truck is similarly equipped. So all the same people are in it, dogs, tools, that kind of stuff, same amount of fuel. So this is usually easiest to do after a fill up, if the campground's not too far away. If it is, then fill up again before you get back on through your reway. That way your truck is, you know, dealing with the same configuration, because this is the whole point. You're going to use that information to come up with your numbers, and it has to be the same truck as when it went through the first time. So now you've gone through there twice and you've got two weight tickets. And let's pretend that your first weigh-in was 5,100 on the steer axle, 8,600 on the drive axle. The trailer was 16,200 pounds for a total of 29,900 pounds. These are your gross axle weights and should be lower than your GAWR for each axle. The sum of these two numbers equals 13,700, and that provides your truck's GVW, which should be less than your GVWR. That's the maximum your truck is weighing when you're towing your RV. This number, 29,900, is your GCW. That's your gross combined weight, and your GCW should be less than your rating, your GCWR. To get the rest of our numbers, we need to bring in that second ticket with just your truck weight on it. So here we're going to say that you got a steer axle weight of 5,000, a drive axle of 4,100, trailer of course is zero because it's not there, and a total of 9,100 pounds. To get our pin weight, we need to take the sum of these two numbers minus the sum of these two. One mistake I see online is that people will only look at that rear axle, but when you put a pin on the hitch in your truck, it's going to add weight to the whole truck, not just the rear axle. So in this case, we're looking at 13,700 pounds for the sum of the truck on the first ticket, and then 9,100 pounds on the second ticket, giving us a difference of 4,600 pounds, and that is the pin weight we're looking at. And we're going to come back to this number in just a minute. To get the total weight of the RV, all we need to do is subtract the totals on both of the tickets. So 29,900 pounds minus 9,100 pounds would give us a total weight of the RV of 20,800 pounds. That is the GVW of the RV. And just like every other one that we've done here, the GVW needs to be less than or equal to the GVWR. So now if you're curious, you can calculate your pin weight percentage by just taking the GVW, the weight of the actual RV, divided by the pin weight. In this case, we're looking at about 22%. And honestly, this 22% is a number that I've seen in both RVs as we've weighed them. 22 seems to be pretty common for toy hauler with a bunch of stuff up front, right? We've got a heavy mattress, we've got a generator, we've got inverters and batteries. So 22% is a pretty good guess if you want to use that for your pre-calculations. So if you found this video helpful, please click that thumbs up button. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know down in the comments if you've had any surprises at the cat scales. Thank you for watching. Safe travels to you, and we will see you next week.